Let's go back to adding things to our chart. Remember from the intro video that this course was going to involve a version control system called Git? You might be wondering how Git got its name. It was created in 2005 by Linus Torvalds. Git is British slang for something roughly equivalent to unpleasant person. Torvalds once said, "I'm an egotistical bastard, and I name all my projects after myself. First Linux, now Git." Git was designed with code in mind. It's not the only system built with that goal, though. One early, widely adopted version control system for code is called CVS, Concurrent Version Systems. Another system, SVN, also known as Subversion, is fairly similar, but improved on CVS to some extent. Another system you may have heard of is called Mercurial, abbreviated HG, the elemental symbol for Mercury. Mercurial has a lot in common with Git, and CVS and SVN are pretty similar, so to avoid cluttering up our chart, I'll just add SVN and leave the others off. Let's go ahead and fill in the chart for our new entries. All right, so which of these systems have the user manually saving versus auto-saving? Well, clearly manual saving requires you to manually save. Wikipedia also requires this. So does SVN. Dropbox and Google Docs, on the other hand, save versions for you, whether or not you manually save. So what does Git do? Git takes the manual approach, allowing the user to choose when to create checkpoints. While it may seem like having changes saved automatically would be convenient or nice, Git's system makes it much more likely that each individual version will represent a logical change. We'll expand on why this is useful later, but intuitively, being able to view old versions is much more useful if each checkpoint is meaningful. In Git terminology, these user-created checkpoints are called commits. Commits are the basic building blocks of Git, each one representing a version of the content at one point in time. Git requires the user to supply a commit message each time a commit is created. This makes looking through old versions much more useful and pleasant than the Google Docs model, assuming that the user supplied a useful commit message. You'll actually get a chance to see what this looks like in Git soon with Caroline.